I work with biotechnology as a medium, and I use that as a medium for critical practice and reflection on the interaction between biotechnology and society. Facial recognition consists of a kind of system with various components, and facial recognition systems are used to identify people and connect them with images that are stored in a database. So we encounter facial recognition systems when we use our phones, when we post things on social media, Facebook, Instagram. We encounter facial recognition on the street via surveillance cameras and the software that's used by police, for example, to figure out if there's people of interest that are on the street that are being tracked. And so facial recognition describes this effort to match a person's face to an identity via an image. And a facial recognition system consists of a few different components. So the first component is detection. So that means looking at a picture and saying there's a face there. The second component is sometimes normalization. So like if you're looking to the side, maybe you need to re-skew the image a bit. And then the third part is this identity matching part. And so that consists of saying, okay, we have these identities in a database. We have this picture. Does it match any of them? So it's this matching part of it. So, and then the facial recognition system is kind of all of this together. How Do You See Me is the project that I worked on for Photographers Gallery. And this is an effort to look back at the cameras that are looking at us all the time. So to try to understand what is happening inside of the facial recognition system. How does it see me? I am being looked at all the time by cameras on the phone, on my computer, on my iPad, on the street, and they're always looking at me, but I want to look back at them. And so in How Do You See Me, I use algorithms to get closer, in a sense, to the algorithmic processes that process images. I use a kind of genetic algorithm. So I use computational tools that are inspired by evolution to generate a population of images. And these images over time cross over and mutate. And the ones that are the most recognized as being similar to me continue and propagate. And so what happens over time is that the images shift, and over hundreds of generations, suddenly you have images that facial recognition systems detect as being a face or detect as being my face. And that is a way of looking inside the system and trying to understand how does the system actually see. Because these facial recognition systems are like alien intelligences. They're things that we can't understand. We can't directly ask and we can't directly look because of these kind of black boxes. And so How Do You See Me is this effort to kind of probe the black box and try to understand how it's structured. My process involves a lot of programming and creating these complex systems of code that I don't even understand. So I start, you know, with a blank page and line by line build an increasingly complex system. And at a certain point, it's really beyond me, actually, even what's going on there. But it generates these really interesting images. And then it's always this kind of sifting through the images and seeing, you know, what is interesting and what is, you know, what is achieving its goals and my own aesthetic goals and so on. So the process is also this kind of curation of images process. So there's two videos in the project. One is detection and one is recognition. And so if you look at the detection video, you'll see what does the facial recognition system think is a face? And what comes up over and over and over again in many generations, in many runs of the algorithm, is this kind of white oval. And that is very revealing about these kind of stereotypes that are embedded within facial recognition, within facial detection technology. And so that's a very direct and very political connection to the context of the data set. And then we have the recognition video, and that's much more complex and nuanced and sort of maybe a bit more poetic. But what you see is that there's these totally strange vectors within the system that are neighboring to the vector that represents my face, that we would never, that makes no sense to us, and that, frankly, we don't want in any kind of deployed facial recognition system, because what would that even mean? That there are these kind of latent possibilities lurking in there, that something completely different than my face could also be just as well recognized as me. And so that gets at the question of authority and the question of power, and what does it mean that we give these systems this pretense of objectivity, and that we allow them to make decisions, and that we put so much trust and faith in automated technologies. So that begins to kind of open that discussion up a bit.